Welcome back, guys. We are in Lost Dutchman State Park. The date is, where you got to be in the December 15th?
Very good.
Let's see.
Look at you go.
We're in, we've been in Lost Dutchman for about, what, 2 to 3 weeks now?
This is the second week.
Second week. And we haven't been doing a lot, you know, a little bit of day hikes and just kind of
chilling,
relaxing a little bit. This video here that we're going to do is about our
week-long hike in the Catalina Mountains.
Yeah, last would have been December. Man, I can't remember anything right now.
January. It was last January.
29.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, we're trying to remember a year ago.
You do the math.
Yeah, exactly. We did a 1 week backpack trip. We had stayed previously at Catalina State Park. And we decided, you know, it was just so awesome up there. We wanted to do a 1 week hike. So we put the camper in storage.
Yep.
And what was cool is we were trying to figure out how to get a ride. We were on the other side of Tucson. And we went and put in an ad or just a little posting in one of the buildings, one of the meeting rooms, saying we were looking for a ride over to the park and back. And that day I put the note up while we started talking to this couple right next to us, and they're full-time, they live full-time in their fifth wheel. They offered to drive us over to the park and then pick us up a week later, so it worked out just great.
Oh yeah, it was awesome.
It was Martin and Laura.
Yep.
So a quick little story about those guys. They're full-time RVers. I believe they design zoo exhibits all over the world. So they do, I think he had an engineering background and she had a graphic design. So, you know, they'll go to a zoo and develop a new display or a new, you know, whatever,
exhibit.
Yeah. And then they'll spend the rest of the time in their fifth wheel basically designing and working on it. So, I mean, that's kind of a cool way to make a living. But anyhow, enough about them. They were an excellent couple. They were really cool.
Yeah, I really like them.
They took us over there and they decided to hike up part way with us, so that was great. They hiked up the first,
I don't know,
a couple miles probably.
It was really cool because Martin was kind of in awe of our packs, and he just had this little day pack with some water in it, and he's like, oh, here, let me try your pack. So he had to throw my pack on. He hiked for a bit with that. And then he grabbed Eric's.
Then he grabbed my pack. And he was just so intrigued with the whole, you know, backpacking thing. I don't know if she was really into it, but he thought it was just cool. Of course, I think he's from Germany. And
yeah.
I think they do a ton of hiking over there. So that was really cool. They saw us, you know, halfway up a couple miles in and then said goodbye. And basically we weren't going to see them for another week. I don't think we saw another person for another week.
Oh no, it wasn't until on the way back down.
Yeah, the cool thing about this hike is, you know, we start out in the desert floor. So, I mean, it's, you know, 1,000 foot elevation and it's all cactus. It's a lot like this, you know, saguaro and cholla. And the ultimate goal, we were going to hike to the top of Mount Lemmon. I can't remember what the elevation is.
Man, I wanted to say I thought it was 7 8.
I was thinking it was 9,000 feet.
Something like that.
I do know that Mount Lemmon is the southernmost ski resort in the United States.
Yeah. so how crazy is that?
So, in theory, we're going to hike from desert all the way up through into, you know, pine forests and snow. What we didn't know, we kind of knew, but we didn't know to the extent, is the weather that was coming in. It was just a historic rainfall. I think they had, like, 6-7 inches of rain.
Oh my god, yeah.
And they were supposed to get like 14 inches of snow in the upper elevations.
Yeah. Oh yeah, there was at least a foot of snow.
Where we ended up base camping, or where we ended up camping, where we made it to our second day, you could see snow about 1,000 foot above us and ice. And that really sucked because we were at that medium spot. I think I'd rather be completely frozen and in snow than in that 34 degrees cold wet rain.
Yeah.
You know, and so the first day we hiked up, it was beautiful, you know, shorts, t-shirts, 60 degrees, and camp that night, it was in the 40s.
It started raining that night.
Yeah. And
the next day, I mean, we had, there was a break. There was a little bit of break, I don't know, it was like 11 or something like that in the morning. We were like, okay, what should we do? Should we just go for it? Or should we like sit tight or whatever? We were like, well, we didn't want to sit tight. We thought, okay, let's just go for it, you know, just do this. So as soon as we got everything all packed up or whatever, it started raining again.
And we hiked, you know, for another 4 hours, and that was a very aggressive hike.
Very aggressive. A lot of it was like just shrubbery.
And trees, and it was so steep in the end. I mean, it was like 1,000 foot in that last half mile or whatever.
Oh, yeah.
So we hiked all day in the rain, completely soaked, you know, and the temperature, obviously, the more we went up, the temperature dropped, plus the storm was moving through. So it's, you know, 41 degrees, we're completely soaked, raining like crazy, and we got to the spot at, you know, 3-4 o'clock in the afternoon and couldn't even see where we were at.
No.
Just found this little spot, set up the tent, thought there was like kind of mountains around us, you know, I mean, but it was nothing but clouds and fog and rain, I mean.
Just couldn't see a thing.
So then we ended up sitting there, and it rained all the rest of that day. We were drenched. Everything we had was wet.
Oh, yeah.
And it was cold, you know, and you know, I've experienced mild hypothermia before. I know my brother's watching this, he's going to be busting my balls, but it was a similar thing. We went out, you know, wearing shorts, we hiked all day, it was perfectly warm, it was 45, 50 degrees, hiked all day, got soaked because it rained all day, and that night, you know, I started, you know, losing brain function, and my hands weren't working, and just mild hypothermia started to set in, and it's not a good feeling. So, you know, this is kind of where we were again, or where I was again, and everything we have is wet. Temperature's dropping, you know, it's supposed to be below freezing that night, so we just basically...
We hunkered down.
Hunkered down, sat in the tent.
And we didn't leave at all, and what really sucked is when we had to go get water.
Yeah, I mean, you
so there was nothing dry, so you may as well just throw on wet shoes.
Put on wet clothes, you walk the quarter mile to go and get water, whatever you got to do, and then get back in the tent. And that is, all the hiking we've done, that is the longest amount of time I've spent in a tent.
Oh, by far, yeah.
It was crazy. So it rained all the next day, and that was, you know, according to our plan, that was supposed to be a hike day. We were going to hike up another 3,000 or 4,000 feet. And get up to Mount Lemmon. Well, we just sat there. The other thing is, I started getting sick that day.
Oh, yeah.
Sicker than shit. I mean, just cold and fever
sneezing.
And
it wasn't pretty.
So, sat in the tent all that day. And then the next day, the sun came out and we kind of dried out some of our stuff a little bit. Then you started getting sick. I started feeling a little better. And,
so it just kind of went back and forth, you know?
Yeah. I mean, it was an all-day process to get our gear dried out.
It looked like a freaking garage sale. Every bush or every little stick or limb just had some article of clothing on it.
But, I mean, when you're sitting in basically the clouds, I mean, it was a matter of, like, you know, we'd have to wait for that break when the clouds would move out, you know, and clouds equals mist and fog damp and... And then a little bit of sunshine would come through for 2 hours, and we're hanging out all our stuff and trying to get it, you know, dried out and trying to warm up ourselves. And then, you know, out of the blue, the clouds would come in again. And I remember that night, I mean, it was like watching a river. The clouds just started pouring over the tops of the hills and dropping into our little valley and filling it up. I mean, it was just extraordinary to watch. But
It was amazing.
I just couldn't escape that dampness, you know, and... So we got all our gear dried out, and, you know, we sat through that third day.
Yep.
That would have been third day we sat through.
It was that afternoon is when it finally stopped.
Yeah, when it finally the clouds moved out and the rain stopped.
And, I mean, it was crazy because the sun was out and all those clouds were around us, and it was like we were in a bowl with just clouds completely around us, and they just... slowly started
dissipating. Yeah, when everything, you know, got, you know, the clouds finally moved out, we're sitting on this little point surrounded by like mountains all the way around us, and it was extraordinary. I mean, it was so beautiful. We were just rewarded with the most spectacular views, and it was just a great trip. So then that fourth day, you know, we decided to stay. At that point, we just did a day trip. And so we left the base camp there, and we just took, you know, what gear we had. You weren't feeling that well. I wasn't feeling that well.
I just took a day pack. And
so then we took the day, and we just hiked up another, I think it was another 1,500 feet or so. And we didn't make it all the way to Mount Lemmon, but we made it up into, you know, just beautiful pine forest and spectacular views.
Oh, it was so gorgeous.
It was awesome.
And it was really cool because, I mean, we could see the snow on the top of Mount Lemmon, you know.
Yeah, it was just crazy. Especially, you know, thinking, you know, 48 hours earlier, you're sitting down in, you know, a hot desert. And, now you're looking at, you know, snow. And there was snow in some of the spots in the shadows. And,
oh, yeah.
You know,
yep.
So, I mean, obviously it snowed pretty good, but.
But I tell you, nothing beats, I just love the pines. Nothing beats being in the pines on a beautiful sunny day up on a mountain.
Yeah, it was pretty cool. So, you know, then we hiked back that day and kind of licked our wounds. And the following day we got up and we hiked back down to the Romero Pools.
Yep.
So that would have been day six, so that we could meet those guys on day seven to pick us up. And it was a great hike down. You know, it was warm. I forgot, you know, hiking back down, I actually counted how many streams we crossed.
Oh, yeah.
And I think it was like 32 or 35.
Yep.
Well, on the way up, we're hiking through this historic, you know, 6-8 inches of rain they got. And, you know, you got a 60-pound backpack on your back, and you're hiking through, you know, fast-moving water up to your knees.
Okay, it's up to here on me.
It wasn't that deep.
If it's up to your knees, it is.
But, you know, you're balancing this pack, and you're on slippery rocks, fast-moving current. That really slowed us down on our way up.
And it was, I mean, there was some sketchy spots because we didn't know where to cross because, I mean, that water was just rushing. You know, normally on a good day, there's just all kinds of rocks or whatever. You can see where to cross. It's like, no problem. You just skip across, you're good to go.
Right.
But...
And on the way, like I said, I counted how many streams we crossed on the way back down. Half of them weren't even streams. On the way up, with all that historic rain, I mean, it was completely dry.
They were rivers.
Basins to, yeah, I mean, you've got, you know, a 20-foot span. Look at that.
What the hell is that?
What do you think? It's a javelina.
Oh, my
God,
it is.
Two of them. I'm going to pause this. Hold on. We have javelina right in the park. This is crazy. First time I've ever seen javelina right in the park. These guys are right here. I didn't even know they had javelina up here. That was pretty wild to see javelina come right through. Man, look, they're huge. I've seen them before and I didn't realize how big they were. They're the size of koda.
Oh, yeah.
They're big. Big and beefy. Cool. You guys got to see some javelina.
Yeah, rock on.
And we saw today we were doing a hike. And, I mean, we've had coyotes coming right up to the back of the little camping area here. But we were on a hike today and we kicked out two coyotes. Up in the hills, up in the rocks. That was pretty interesting.
They were little babies, weren't they?
No, they were
good size. Oh, were they?
Yeah, they had crazy color. Gray.
Red.
Yeah, well.
Okay.
Okay, so back to, I don't even remember what we were talking about.
We were talking about the streams, rivers.
The stream crossing was just insane on the way up. I mean, it was a cumbersome hike that last...
Yeah, it was. It really was.
You know, I don't even know. I think it was only like 4 miles or something, but it probably took us 5-6 hours.
Oh, yeah.
It was a brutal hike. It was steep. There was a lot of trees down, and
Yeah, we
had to climb over.
I forgot how many of those. I counted those too.
And then to get, you know, up into a cloud is basically where we camped.
Yeah.
There's a snowstorm coming. Where are you going? Where are you going from South Dakota to go up to a snowstorm? That's what I want to know.
Because we're mad.
Yeah, you're nomad. You're mad.
Thank you.
cooking in the tent. Because we are freezing our asses off.
And it's like been a downpour pretty much all day.
All day. So we're down to our last few dry clothes, and we're sitting in the tent. Everything we have is soaked. I mean, everything is soaked. I think we're in a pretty cool spot, but you can't really tell because it's a giant cloud. That's a mountain over there somewhere.
Good times.
Good times. Yeah. We're losing.
Ah! Are you here with me? Just looking out on the day of another dream, where you can't get what you want, but you can get me. So let's set out to see me, love. 'Cause you are my medicine when you're close to me. When you're close to me.
Through that, it was great. The sixth day, we got back down into warmer. It was so nice after, you know, freezing and rain and sitting in the tent. We had beautiful sunny evening. I think you were napping in the tent.
Oh yeah, it felt so good.
I think I went down in the stream and was cooling off and checking out the waterfalls, because that's the Romero pools where
yep.
all the
that was the first time we'd seen
are.
People the whole trip.
Yeah, I hadn't seen people for 5-6 days.
Coda wants to play.
Coda,
that's gonna...
you're nuts.
Okay. camera's going down.
No, I dare take her off the leash.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes. Only if you're good. You gotta sit. Sit. And you gotta be a good girl. We're talking about, oh my god, she's gonna explode. We're talking about our hiking trip. Coda. Sit. No, I'm not throwing your tire. You're nuts.
Okay, so that was that trip and hike, and then we got out. We met up with those guys. They picked us up.
It was cool because those guys were really excited to see us or whatever, and Laura felt really bad, so she brought a bag of fruit. She's like, you guys gotta have some real food by now. It was nice to eat an apple.
Yeah, they're really cool. I mean,
we love those guys.
Yeah.
Hope they're doing well.
They happen. If you guys happen to watch this, we really appreciate the ride up there and wish you guys the best.
But and I hope to see you this winter too.
That was cool. Yeah, that'd be nice.
So that was that, and then I think we grabbed some fast, greasy fast food because we were hungry for calories. And
oh, that's right. He was talking Burger King for like. I think it was like the third day into the hike. So it's like every half hour. I really wish I had a Burger King. Is it Big Mac? What do they have there? What's a Burger King?
Whopper.
Oh, Whopper. Oh, I want a Whopper.
I think we ended up doing McDonald's.
Yeah, we did.
I can't remember, but.
Yeah.
So we packed up and we headed south. We went down to Patagonia.
Yes.
State Park. And did I think we... You guys hear the coyotes?
Said the coyotes. Oh yeah, they're close.
Yeah, there's coyotes everywhere in this part.
So, anyways.
Let them hear the coyotes. Yeah, the amount of coyotes you hear in the evening and morning is just amazing.
Awesome.
I want to see a coyote and a javelina fight. I wonder who would win.
I'd say the coyote.
Lay.
Because some
no.
Guys...
Sit. Lay. Lay. You're psycho.
Psycho. Oh my
god. All right, anyhow, guys, we'll probably be back next week. We've been in an internet hole here, so we have, like, no internet for, like, going
sucks.
On 2 weeks. So I'm not able to upload anything. But hopefully next week I'll do a little just kind of recap of everything we're doing at the park here and give you guys an update. It's been great to be back and appreciate all the comments from everybody. Guys,
keep them coming.
Followed us last year and, you know, new subscribers, but... Everybody that kind of hung with us from last year, and you know who you are. Thank you
we
very
know
much.
Who you are.
We mean it. We appreciate it. You guys take care. Thanks.
All right. Thanks, guys.
Coda's nuts.
Yeah, I know.